Shalom, this is your Ark, Yah is Magnified, coming back with another informative video. This video is titled Praecipe. So with that being said, let's get to it. Oh yeah, but hold on guys, before I move further, I'd like to state for the record, I'm not a lawyer, I do not practice law, and I do not pretend to. All my videos are for informational and educational purposes only. They're all facts and all truth, nothing more, nothing less. So with that being said though, let's get it. Okay, so now, matter of fact, before I go on this precipice thing, you know, this is going to be a wonderful lesson. But before I get on this topic, I want to make a quick statement. Guys, pay close attention to what's going on, okay? I made a video talking about contracts. Now you have Mr. Constitutional over there. I'm an Osiris, the fraud of law. Now he's all of a sudden dealing in contract law. Negro, please, if you don't sit down somewhere, if you better go back to that federal manual child support that you always deal with. You know what I mean? The guy, he's trying to put his pitch slowly but surely. For one, he's trying to ride my coattail. He want to learn instead of just asking me to teach him, you know, and make a donation for I can teach him. He wants to try to downcredit me, but then try to steal my method. It ain't gonna happen though, I'm an Osiris, because you're too stupid. So now with that being said though, guys, let's pick this up at Praecipe. Praecipe, man, this is an original writ, man. This writ is so powerful, man. A lot of guys don't have a clue what Praecipe is. You never heard nobody talk about it, Harley. You know, everybody doing child support, you never heard them talk about the Praecipe. I guarantee you. Why? Because they're not on that level yet. They didn't make it there yet. You know, these guys are still fighting the basics. And they've been doing this for years now. Still fighting the basics. Okay? So now, let's talk about this Praecipe thing. Let's read the definition. This is coming out of the third edition of the Black Law Dictionary. It says, Praecipe, Latin, in practice, an original writ drawn up in the alternative, commanding the defendant to do the thing required or show the reason why he had not done it. So now, the best place to be when you're doing a Praecipe is the plaintiff. I hate using the word plaintiff, you know. I deal with claimant, but just for argument's sake, we're going to say plaintiff. Okay? So now, if you're the plaintiff and you're commanding the defendant to do something, then how powerful is this writ? A lot of guys not going to understand what I'm talking about, but hey, just put your mind to this. If you are the plaintiff and they are the defendant and you're telling the defendant that you want them to do something, not telling, you're commanding the defendant to do something and they must do it. How powerful is this writ? You know? So now, I told y'all in my last video, it's two steps to freedom. The first step is freedom. Getting free. That's the first step. That's the first thing you want to do is seek freedom. After you get that freedom, you go for remedy, you know, which is payback, payday, money. Okay? So when you're going for your remedy, that means that you are now you're now pursuing them. You became the predator. They became the prey. It's time to eat, man. Plain and simple, simple and plain. Two steps. Okay? Now let's go forward, though. It says, a slip of paper. What I tell y'all paper was in my last video. It's a tool. You got to use the right tools at the right time. You're just not going to go into court and file a Praecipe in court and think you're going to get whoever you're filing against to do something. It ain't going to work like that. You know, it's steps and rules of etiquette to doing everything. Okay, but let's continue. It says upon which the particulars of a writ are written, it is lodged in the office out of which the required writ is to issue. So most of these writs will be placed in what? The clerk of the court. Okay, how powerful is the clerk of the court? The clerk of the court is real powerful. Those pro-throw notaries, they are notaries. They are powerful beyond belief, man. But let's continue. It says, as an order written out and signed, addressed to the clerk of the court and requesting him to issue a particular writ. So how powerful is the clerk of the court if he can issue this writ? Clerks of the court, especially a chief clerk of the court, is a pro tro notary. Back to the common law, baby. Okay. So now with that being said, let's go somewhere else to get more understanding of a Praecipe. Okay, so let's pick this up at the top. Praecipe. It's a noun, right? It says an order requesting a writ or other legal document. Historical. A writ demanding action or an explanation of a non-action. Okay? This is a powerful writ, guys. I'm trying to tell you. So let's stroll up. It has the Latin origin and it also has the English origin. Since we're dealing in English, the English origin is precept. So now let's go to the definition of precept. Precept, guys. It says a general rule intended to regulate behavior or thought. Stroll up. A writ or warrant. Okay? A writ or warrant. So let's read the sentence. The commissioner issued precepts requiring the companies to provide information. It's a warrant. So now you have guys who tell you to file a habeas corpus when you should actually be getting your ducks in a row so you can file warrants. This is another level, man. A totally different level. Okay? Totally different level, guys. So now, with that being said, let's go to someone else. I mean, somewhere else where we can get more understanding of Praecipe. So let's go there, guys. Okay, guys. So let's pick this up with Pennsylvania. For all my peoples out of Pennsylvania watching the videos, you know, hey, this is another gem band drop. Pick it up, dust it off, you know. Study. If you guys need my help, hey, come over here and get this remedy, man. But let's stroll up. This is Rule 1037, judgment upon default or admission, assessment of damages. Let's stroll up to B. B, the pro-tro notary. So what is a pro-tro notary, guys? We're going to deal with the pro-tro notary later. We're going to go over that in this video. But first, let's read this read a few paragraphs out of this. It says, the pro-tro notary or Praecipe of the plaintiff. Like I told you guys, you want to be the plaintiff. You shall enter judgment against the defendant for failure to file within the required time a pleading to a complaint which contains a notice to defend or except as provided by subdivision D for any relief admitted to be due by the defendant's pleading. Okay? That's why you want to be the plaintiff. Okay? When you're dealing with a Praecipe, because you get judgment, and if you get judgment, you get paid. You hear me? No refunds, you get money, you get paid. But let's continue. It says, see Rule 237.1, which requires the Praecipe for default judgment to contain a certification of written notice of intent to file the Praecipe. So again, if you file a Praecipe, you just can't go in there and think you're going to file one and then you're going to get remedy. No, it don't work that way, guys. You must be ready. So now, like I tell you all, you need that remedy. Hey, another level over here, man. Hey, this level over here, man, is different. I'm trying to tell you guys. But let's continue. While the pro-tro notary may enter a judgment, may enter a default judgment in an action legal or equitable, only the court may grant equitable relief. See subdivision D. But let's continue. Pick this up at 1. The pro-tro notary shall assess damages for the amount to which the plaintiff is entitled if it is a sum certain or which can be made certain by computation. But if it is not, the damages shall be assessed at a trial at which the issues shall be limited to the amount of damages. Okay? So again, what is this whole thing is talking about? It's talking about remedy. Seeking pay, getting your money. You see? That's the difference, guys. Another level, man. You hear me? Another level. Let's go, though. It says, in all actions in which only damages to be assessed are the cause of the repairs made to property. Okay? But now, we're going to go to what a proto-notary is so we get an understanding of that. Okay? I don't want to be doing this all day, so let's go there. Okay, guys. So now, let's pick this up where it says proto-notary, right? Proto-notary, the title given to an officer who officiates as principal clerk of some courts. So again, guys, the first thing I asked you all was how powerful is the clerk of the court? How powerful is the clerk of the court? But now, we're going to go somewhere else, though, to get more understanding of a proto-notary. So let's go. Okay, so you guys ready to go in? Let's go. It says, what is a proto-notary? The office of the proto-notary. The proto-notary is the chief clerk and record keeper for all filings related to civil cases, right? Remember, civil cases. Let's continue. The office is located in the county courthouse and responsible for the filing, recording, and processing of all civil actions, equity actions, judgments, federal and local tax liens, city liens, family court matters. Now, why would family court matters be done in civil cases? Because it's all civil, man. It's a civil matter. Okay? Arbitrations, license suspensions, appeals, appeals to higher courts, uniform commercial code filings, and applications for passports. So, guys, again, how powerful is the proto-notary if it handles all of this? And the main one we worried about is family court matters. Hey, man. Hey. Hey, I'm telling y'all. But hold on. Let's go here, too. And civil cases. That we worried about. Oh, no. And one more thing. One more thing, guys. Well, two more. Two more. Right? We worried about equity actions and judgments. Okay? So with that being said, though, man, you all need my help, man. Come and get this remedy. You know? Proof upon proof upon proof upon proof. A different level over here, man. Who cares what the weirdos say? They all weirdos. The facts are gonna be the facts, and I'm gonna bring that truth out, man. From the beginning. Keep your eyes open, man. Got big things coming. You know, you all need my help. Like I said, hit me up at yardsmagnified@gmail.com. Donate. Get the ball rolling, man. You know, let's get to this remedy. More people need to seek that remedy and get free, man. So with that being said, shalom.